tragedy occurred to the Bee Gees. A young brother, Andy, dies by his own hand, right?
Well, we think so.
Is that the general thinking?
We think so. You know, if you're an addict, which Andy was, you can only really help yourself. Other people just wring their hands, and parents can't do anything. He eventually came here to escape from us trying to stop him from doing the things that were
bad. He was baby brother, though, wasn't he?
Yeah.
Yeah, he was. He was 30 years old when he died. He actually just had his 30th birthday when he died. And he actually died in my home in England. And he'd come over for a couple of weeks, and he was in a bad way. And it affected his heart, the drugs and everything, and years of abuse.
Well, what's the name of the disease?
Myocarditis he had.
Yes.
But
he
had a condition.
Virus of the heart.
Yeah,
well,
that's right.
Caused through seizures.
It's an inflammation and a virus of the muscle
around
the
heart.
But apparently, it was a condition that you often see in people who do abuse themselves in a way. They drink a lot, they don't eat, they don't sleep, and they run.
Was he a talent?
Yeah. Oh,
yeah. Oh, yeah. Did he sing with you?
Yeah. I mean, the door was open for him. We were hoping that he would.
Had he been singing with you?
Yeah. Yeah.
In and out?
But we all worked together anyway on his records and
did he write too?
Yes.
Yeah.
He was quite a good writer. He was really developing. Mm. And I think for about 10 years, there was always that 10-year difference. We were always 10 years older than him, so it was never right for Andy to be in the band, and Andy never felt right about being in the band. He wanted to be, but he was never quite old enough. And
did you want him eventually to be a BG?
Yes.
The one album actually was going to be the album with the four of us together.
89, yeah.
Where were you when he died, guys?
We were in Miami by 09.
I
was in England where he died, and he actually died at the John Radcliffe Hospital in Oxford, which was about 10 minutes from my house, but he actually collapsed in my house.
And Dad called me about 6 in the morning.
And the irony about this disease, you know, of alcoholism addiction and drug addiction, is just the weirdest things come out. And he said to Mum in the ambulance on the way was, "You can't die from this, can you, Mum?" And 3 days later, he died. And my mum is still stuck with that. And to see the grief that the parents have for the youngest child, to our grief for the youngest brother.
Parents.
We learned a hell of a lot about each other and our mum and dad.
Mum is still alive?
Yes. Yep.
She's in Vegas. She lives in Vegas and loves it.
Yeah. Dad passed away.
Dad's gone.
Do you often think about him?
Of course. I love it. The loveliest thing about Dad passing away, which is a funny thing to say, but he was much older, but he wanted to be with Andy. So
it's
much.
It's the youngest child thing.
Literally died when Andy died.
I think it was a guilt thing.
Yeah, he was very bitter for 3 years after that. And then when he passed away, I felt real good that he was now with Andy. In fact, at his funeral, the people that were there that he'd met in this business over the years, from the Mills Brothers were his favorite group, and Donald Mills was at his funeral. Sure. So you can imagine how I said to them, if he was here now, he'd be filming this. Because
did
that's
you,
the way he was.
Continue to work or take some time off? What did you do after that?
After Andy's death, we went straight. We were always in the studio, and that album really became Andy's album to us, the one album, which features the songs like Wish You Were Here or Tears. So there's quite a few songs on that album that reflected our feelings for Andy. It was very
hard to work?
Yes.
Yeah, it was a little bit, but I think we found some kind of comfort in work. I think when things like that happen, you have to throw yourself into work.
Stands forever. Now that I've done love, and yes, there will be tears. Sleep tonight. There will be tears.